Mr. Mangala Samaravira, former Christian Nations slavery advice seeking and slavery type believer, rather, who really like, okay, you can believe, some people believe when they don't know the, you know, the correct path. That's why you believe. Now, those days when, for example, I'm not going to undermine the Christian religion, no, Islam religion, no, Judaism religion, no. 50% of the Hinduism religion based on belief. But the thing is, you know, if you take, for example, the U.S. Marines, you know, that person assassinated President John F. Kennedy, the U.S. owns young president at that time, on the belief that is good for USA, right? So U.S. continued and the globalization came. The whole space program got abruptly ended according to the U.S. own preferences, right? It's up to the U.S. to do this way. But then you can see after several decades, what happened? The U.S. president, you know, some other influences are right now here in Sri Lanka, right? Now what happens? The China is emerging and the everywhere, if not only China, the US, the whole world, there is a crisis. That is why just believing something and killing President John F. Kennedy did not make the result here. That proves that the belief is blind. Rather, it's like, you know, those days, the Portuguese initially, then the Dutch, Dutch people from the Netherlands, and also, you know, they just sail from the North Atlantic Ocean, okay, not knowing where to go. Okay, you can say, for example, the Portuguese, you know, they wanted to sail to India. They knew there is a India between the China and the West, from which the Ottoman Empire of Turkey brought the goods. And also, they did not know it. There was a Ceylon, Sri Lanka at that time. Okay, so they thought it's coming through the to West, through the Muslim traders of Turkey, Ottoman Empire, through India. So they was charged exorbitant prices by these Muslim traders in Arab, Ottoman Empire, because they kept a margin to them and they sold to Europeans. Therefore, in order to overcome this problem, since they don't have a Europeans, Portuguese, Dutch, or the generally Europeans don't have a land route to Asia, which China now promotes upon my advice, the Belt and Road Initiative. Okay, so now the thing is, when I go back to the topic, the Portuguese decided to overcome the exorbitant Islam Muslim traders' prices, and they've sailed, you know, based on a belief. They sailed from, you know, North Atlantic Ocean in European side, believing they will be able to transact by going down and to the hope of Cape of Good Hope, and then you know, enter the Indian Ocean, coming towards India. So they finally, you know, there was a huge gale, and Portuguese could not locate India. They came to Gaul. They landed somewhere else in Gaul, right? In Gaul, southern Sri Lankan. So that blind faith, okay, without knowing where to go, just having a belief, okay, we are going to a place called India, without knowing how to navigate, without exactly knowing where you are heading. Similarly in life, human life, without knowing, okay, what to do, what are the good things to do, what are the right things to do, what are the bad things to do, what are the wrong things to do, right? And what principle to follow in human life, just by believing, you know, doing all immoral activities and killing and war and everything, believing in the land, as President Trump said of US. Okay, you do like that. And then what happened? Finally, you know, Portuguese landed in Sri Lanka, but it's because of the Sri Lankan people who were kind enough to them, who knew certain principles based on the Gautama Buddha teachings, which are really scientific human principles, not just blind belief, not knowing where life is heading. This is clearly knowing not only life, where the country, where the, you know, even though Sri Lanka is a small country, is trying to survive in the whole world of dominated by Christians and Islam countries and Judaism and Hinduism countries. Still, not believing, based on certain principles of the Gautama Buddha's teachings on human life, Earth, solar system, Milky Way, the space-time universe, and the multiverse universes, those people who were there when the Portuguese landed, look after them, gave food to them, and allowed them to make a port in Gaul. So that port is still there. We preserve it as still part of our heritage. right? Western countries can say it's based on Christian belief this happened. We are saying it's not belief because our principles of morality based on the Gautama Buddha's teaching. That's why we still preserve those Portuguese courts, those churches inside the Dutch or Portuguese courts, everything we preserve, we protect them, right? Those because we are not part of that system, but based on certain principles of the teacher, the great teachers, Gautama Buddha, we do that. So this is where the belief system is wrong, as proven today, right? And that is why I request the U.S. Strategic Command to take away the U.S. economy, the Western nations' beliefs, false, like not knowing and heading, doing something and hoping to go somewhere. That, you know, that came because of a wrong philosophy, right? Religious philosophy. And but to, in order to, we can't change the philosophy of the people because it's there in blood DNA now. We don't want to neither change it. But then in order to overcome this crisis in financial matters and the trade and the, you know, economic issues, U.S. Strategic Command must establish the U.S. financial force and the U.S., the digital force to make sure that, these falls in place in certain principles of human life, wherever it is, whether it's Buddhist countries, Gautama Buddha's teaching countries, or wherever it is on the planet, and certain principles of supporting human life. Because we are not like Iran, we don't believe and do things and attack other countries. We are going on certain principles. That is the reason I request the U.S. U.S. Strategic Command to establish U.S. financial force and the U.S. Digital force for the benefit of every, including the Western Christian, Islamic, and the Judaism countries, and the partly 50% Hindu India, and partly 50% this belief system in India, and also our own countries which follows the Gautama Buddha's teaching, and also China. Based on certain principles and not on a blind faith I have or a belief, not knowing where are heading, not that way, but on a clear direction to get out of this economic crisis due to the pandemic, right, and the financial crisis. That is why I request kindly the U.S. Strategic Command to establish U.S. financial force and the U.S. digital force.